Hi guys and girls, here my new project. I'm planning to create a talk box. And what is a talk box? That's your question. Okay, talk box. I always thought the name for these things was mouth tube, but I was mistaken. The official name for this is talk box. A talk box is a thing, a little speaker with high volume, and this is put into a box. And from this box, there's a tube, and this tube has some length, so you can put it into your mouth, and you are able to articulate the sound coming from the speaker with your mouth, and you can speak with, by example, the sound of an electric guitar or of a synthesizer. Okay, if you like such videos, feel free to press the abo button and click on the bell if you would like to get informed about new videos. Okay, I am living in Germany, so I have a German page here. It's Pauline, and here I have some products. I think you can find it in your country as well, such things for cheap speaker, cheap amplifier, and so on. Okay, I have here a speaker. I open it. One moment. Let's wait for the internet. And here is the speaker. It has a diameter of, what is it here, 116.5 millimeters. It's 46 millimeters in depth. And it has a sinus power of maximum 20 watts. And music wattage is 30 watts. The impedance is 4 ohm. Okay, this thing is cheap. It's below 6 euros. So this I have ordered for my talk box now. And I have an amplifier here. Show you this one. This is the amplifier. Here is the amplification chip, and here you have the outputs for the connection to the speaker. It's a stereo amplifier. I only need one of these channels, and here you can put the here is the input of two channels, and one is a ground pin. Okay, this is a power supply. And you can see here, it's I don't know the English name for it, Hohlbuchse. It's the known power supply for much of these things, and it is 5.5 millimeters and 2.1 millimeters the inner pin, and the plus pole is on the inside. Okay, then I have a power supply for this. This is this thing here, and it has 5 amperes. It's completely sufficient for this thing, and it has the same connection as I need in this for this amplifier. And so I have ordered these three things. I have ordered such a thing here to switch it off. Don't know if I will use this. And I have ordered this input thing here, so I can plug in a thing like a computer, a guitar amp, or a synthesizer. Okay, these are the things I need, and now I will try to create the construction in FreeCAD, but before doing so, I will have a look at the tubing. I will order this at eBay. Here I'm on the eBay thing. You see it's polyvinyl chloride tubing used for aquariums. I don't know, is it aquarium in English? I'm not sure. But it can be used as a tube for transporting water. But in my case, it's transporting sound. So I search, I take 3 meters of this and I use this one, 10 millimeters in the inside, 13 on the outside. It's not too big, so you can put it into your mouth and are able to sing or move your mouth and teeth to form words. Okay, it's €6.50 with shipping in inside Germany, so it's not too expensive. So I am with all things below €30 for the TalkBox. Okay, now let's start a FreeCAD. Oh, this was the wrong thing. I want to use this here, if we can wait a bit until it starts, and then I start creating the box to put this little speaker inside, and the amplifier of course will also be put in this box. So I create a new file. First, I show you which FreeCAD version I am using. I change the language, so this is German. I change it to English, and now I have the things here in English. And now I can show you the FreeCAD version. It's the version 0.19 in the build version 24.276. It's the, by the time, newest version I know of. Okay, so let's start over. I create a new body, and this body gets a name. It's the case. And I create a drawing inside. It's on the XY plane, and create a rectangle. The rectangle should be symmetrically to the midpoint. This way, create another rectangle around it. And this is also symmetric to the midpoint. Okay, now I give this some measurements. This is the length. It should be 180 millimeters in length, but not 180. It should be, edit this one, it should be 180 plus 8. Okay, this measurement should be 150 plus 8. This one gets the 180, and this one the 150. Now these are 4 millimeters thick, and first I select this inner lines here and make them blue, so they are not used for the 3D things I create now. Okay, close it. Here it is. And now create a pad, and it is 4 millimeters in size. Now select the sketch, press Ctrl C, deselect the plane, press OK, press Ctrl V, and now select the sketch and put it into the body. Now I can put this drawing on top of this thing here, and I do this with this function here, select the sketch, this one, flat face, okay, it's okay, and now I have the drawing on top here. I select it and select the inner lines and make them to normal lines again. And now I create a second pad, and this gets a size of 80 millimeters. This is the box I want to create, and it of course gets later some holes in the outside. I will put the amplifier in one of these corners here, and this will get some casing for this amplifier, so these holes don't let sound outside, so you hear too much without when you give tone to it. The tone should be only, or as much as possible, only through the rubber tube in your mouth. Okay, it's a lid, or what did Leo say, a cover, upper shell, a top for this case here. And to create it, I first create a datum plane, and I create a new body. This gets the name cover, and I make the case invisible, the origins I make visible, select the XY plane, so I have it selected, and create a datum plane. There it is, and now I can move this inset direction by 48 millimeters. It's 80 millimeters. I have made the walls high and the 4 millimeters from the bottom. Okay, there it is. Now we can make the case visible again. And on this datum plane, I create a new drawing. I can now copy this sketch here. Take this one. Yeah. I take this one. Press Ctrl C. Only the sketch is selected. Press Ctrl V. Move it into this body, and now select the datum plane and put the sketch on top. That's not the right thing, so I select it here. Perhaps this works. Sketch 2. Okay, now it's working. I put the sketch on this datum plane, make it visible, and select it. And first I make this outer things blue, and this things here, they get another dimensions, not 180 but 179, and this one here 149, so they are a bit smaller by half a millimeter. I can, for security reasons, I could say okay, create 148 and this 178, so it will fit perfect. I want to use some glue to glue it to the top, so it don't need to be very the same size. It will fit better with these measurements here. Okay, take this, close it, and now I create a patch, but it does not go to the outside. It goes into the different direction, and make it 4 millimeters. And now I create a copy of this. And Control V, put this into the cover and put it onto this place here. Sketch 3, here it is. And edit this. Okay, I now want to make the inner parts blue. And the outer part should be visible. The used lines, so now they are green. Close it and create a new pad, and it's also 4 millimeters. Okay, now I am planning to this hole here. It should be in the mid of this box, and we'll get the measurements will be parametrically, so I can change them when I receive the speaker. I can take a caliper and see what holes I really need. To create parametrically holing here, I go to the spreadsheet module and create a new spreadsheet. I give it the name, it's AAA, so I can type in these three letters fast when I use parts from it. And I open this, and here I have some values. The first value is the diameter of speaker, and this should be 102, make it 98 millimeters, and give it a name, properties, alias, and its diameter hole, D hole. So now I need a second parameter. There are four holes on the outside where some screws can be put in, and I'm not sure about the coordinates these holes will be. So I take the 98 divided by 2 and give this value here a bit less than this value. So I have the calculator open. 98 divided by 2, it's 49, and I give it, let's saw, 4 millimeters, 55. Okay, 55. It's hole distance, and give it a name. It's dist holes. Okay. I don't need more values at the time, so I switch back to the part design mode, go into the drawing and create a new drawing here on top of this. And I create a hole in the center here. Switch here to diameter constraining and give this a measurement, and this is AAA.dHole 98 millimeters, that's the hole. And now I put this four holes here, 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 and here, and these diameters are the same, and I give this a diameter about 8 millimeters. They are symmetrically connected. This is also symmetrically, and this one to this also. Does it function? I don't think so. No. This, this, and this, and symmetrical. So now I gave this a measurement here. I take the plus value, this one, and this gets a measurement of AAA dist holes. And this measurement here, it gets the same AAA dot dist holes. And here I have the 5 holes I want to drill into the top of this case. So close it and create a pocket here. This pocket should go through all, and now I have here the place for my speaker. I can put the speaker inside, and here on top there should be created a something like a sphere that covers the speaker, and on the top it has a hole to put in the tubing. So to finish further, I will put a new drawing on top of this. After closing this one, I create a new drawing here, and it is consists on two big circles. These are circles, and now I give them some measurements. This is 140 millimeters, but I create it a bit smaller. Not 140, it is 138, and this one here, it's 150 plus 2, 1, 152. Okay, now I want to drill this into the body, so close it and create a a pocket, but it gets only 2 millimeters. So this is to put the sphere inside. Perhaps it's too near to the holes on the speaker here, so I change it a bit. This gets 140 millimeters, and I think the sphere will be thick enough this way, so make it 142, and this will stay the same, so the sphere will be from 144 to 150. Yes, I think it's thick enough this way, and I have more place here. Okay, close it. There it is. Let's write the measurements on a paper. I have 144 and 150. Now I want to create the sphere on top, so I close this and create a new datum plane. The datum plane, and first a new body. Okay, here's the body. I give it a name. It's a sphere. And it, I make this, first I make this invisible here and create a new datum plane on the XY plane here. Here's a datum plane. Now let's make the cover visible, and now I have to look what is the Z direction. I have the 84 millimeters minus 2 are 82 millimeters. I think this should be the right value, but I've made something wrong. Why? I'm not totally sure. So make it, cancel it, and create the datum plane. The new time sphere is the active body, XY plane, datum plane, and 84, 82 millimeters in Z. So here we are. Make the cover visible again and have a look if it's looking correct. I'm not that sure. No, it's not the right place. I have the 84 plus 4. So double click on the datum plane and change this here. I have the 84 plus 4, 88 minus 2 are 86 millimeters. Yes, this looks better. Okay, use this datum plane now to create the tube. I create a drawing. Now this drawing goes on the XY plane. Now the XZ plane. Will I take XZ? Yes, it's okay. Create a new drawing. I now see I did not really need the datum plane for this thing. So I create here a rectangle, which is going here. Make this visible. So yeah, it's not bad to see where the datum plane is located, because I need now to create the measurement for this point here to this thing. and it's 86 millimeters. There we start. We have these two measurements here. This one I give it the 144 divided by 2, and this one here, it gets this one here, this gets the value of 150 divided by 2. Okay, then I have this size here. It's, let's say, 8 millimeters, and now I want to create a circle. To do so, I create a line going from here to there, and this gets is a construction line, and this is a midpoint for the circles I now create. And create first circle from here. This is the point I want to use, and next one from here, and this is the point I want to use. And this thing gets a hole on the top, so I create a rectangle here. This way it gets the size here, it's 10 millimeters. And now I can create the delete the things we really don't know, don't need. This is this one and this one, but we don't need. This one was not so good. This should be. Oh, it's okay. It's okay. I know how I to construct it. I will now delete the next things we don't need. This one here. This one and this one and this one. And I can delete this one. So this looks okay. Let's have a look here. I'm not sure. There we have something that should be taken off. This one. And I'm not really sure which is blue there. No, it's not. This one can be deleted. So this is the form of the sphere I want to create. I give it here measurement of, let's say, 20 millimeters, and these two should be together, and this these ones should be this way. So I think we've got it not complete. This one is now, you see, it's completely fixed, and I can create the sphere now. Can have a look here, as it looks good. There's much space to put in some glue and perhaps hot glue, to get it very close. Okay, now create the thing. It's the revolve sketch. So I select the sketch and press on revolve. Now this is the tubing here, sphere. Now I go on to the top and create a new sketch there. And this sketch gets a circle, and this gets a diameter. The tube has 30 millimeters, so I might make this 50 millimeters, so the tube can fit inside, and I will wrap some glue or some tape around the tube so it can fit perfect inside here. Okay, I create a hole here, and I create another second hole. This gets a diameter of 10 millimeters. First, I make this blue, and I now I want to create the hole here, but it is not correct. So this one should be deleted, and this one, these are get the same midpoint. Okay, create the first hole here. Go out of the drawing and create the hole. And now I go inside. Twenty-six millimeters, 25, 24, 23, 22, and 21, 20. I'll make it 19 millimeters and press OK and create a copy of this sketch here. Control V, put it into this body and put it on top of here, and put the sketch on this plane, sketch 008. Okay, flat face. Okay, and I now make this one blue, and this one gets green. So press again here, and now I create pocket, but the pocket should be through all, and now I have here the tube will can be inserted to this position and not further. Okay, I think I'm ready with this, so I can make the case visible again, and the the datum planner can make it invisible. So this is the box for the for this talk box, and I think I will get the electronics this week or the next week, and then I can start to change the parameters, so the speaker can be inserted here in this thing, and I want to add some casing part here for the amplifier. I want to create some holes here so the volume control can be reached from outside, because and the power input can also be plugged in from the outside, and this little amplifier will be completely covered, so the box stays, the sound remains inside the box and only goes to your mouth by the tube. So if you are interested in such videos, so please be free to click the Abo button and the clicking on the bell if you like to be informed by new videos. And now have a fine day and many fun. Bye, freecadding. Okay, bye.